Como te chamas?
That's the informal. Como te chamas?
Yeah, how do you call yourself?
Como te chamas? If it's formal,
then I would say como se chama.
So, se instead of te, and the s at the end drops.
It's probably better to learn the formal version because if you don't know somebody's name already, chances are you're going to be treating them formally and not informally. The only situation in which you wouldn't know someone's name and you would treat them informally would be if you are meeting a friend of a friend.
If you're at a party. This is very tricky. The formal, informal people your age or younger go informal unless you are in a professional situation and they are above you. So that's a golden rule. If they're older, treat them formally in any situation. That's what I do.
Depending on what your plans are in Portugal, you might want to focus more on the informal versions of these phrases or the formal versions. So then, if I said, como se chama, then how would you respond?
Eu chamo-me Rui. I call myself Rui. Or, eu sou o Rui.
You're the Rui?
Yes, we like that.
O Rui.
Yeah. O Rui.
Because o is the word for the, if it's masculine, or a for feminine. So I am the Rui. Okay, so eu sou o Joel. Sounds very fancy.
Muito prazer.
Muito prazer. Now we have to...
Now is pleasure.
Muito prazer.
Muito prazer.
A pleasure.
A pleasure. Prazer. Prazer. That R again.
Yeah, it's not prazer. Both of those R's have that flick thing, that flick sound, the prazer. So literally the translation is a lot of pleasure to meet you.
Which it is. Come on.
Muito prazer.
Igualmente.
Igualmente. That's like when we would say the pleasure is mine. Olá, como se chama?
Olá, chamo-me Rui.
Muito prazer.
Igualmente.
Como se chama? Como te chamas?
Eu chamo-me Eduardo.
Learning all the names of the animals in Portuguese will only be useful if you're planning to give a tour at the zoo. This is the kind of specialized vocabulary that you can probably put on the back burner. Instead, focus on the topics that are most relevant to your daily life and what you'll actually need to say in Portuguese conversations. It's much easier to remember something when you have real-life opportunities to put it to use. If you do need to visit a new place like the zoo or maybe the bank, you can find specialized content on our site, practiceportuguese.com. That way, you'll have useful vocabulary and phrases already prepared to help you open your bank account or deposit a check. As an adult, learning a language is about figuring out what you're actually going to use. Unlike children, you won't have the benefits of years of grade school to justify spending an entire week learning all the names of sharks or wildcats. So don't be afraid of changing the order that you learn things to suit your own path and individual goals.